Okay, this video is the continuation of the last video. We were discussing about the output characteristics of common emitter mode of operation of transistor, and we have discussed in the last video about the active region and cutoff region in the output characteristics. Now we will discuss about the saturation region. Now the saturation region, a transistor will operate in the saturation region will only be happen when the collector as well as the emitter junctions both will be forward biased at least by the cut-in voltage. That means both junctions should be forward biased at least by the cut-in voltage. That means both junctions should at least conduct both junctions of the transistor. Under this condition, the collector current becomes approximately independent of the base current. And since the forward biasing voltage for both the junctions is only few tenths of a volt, we can say for a saturation region that VCE in this case, if you refer the circuit of the common emitter mode configuration, that VCE is nothing but difference of VCB minus VEB. So from here, if you leave out the B, you can see that VC minus VE, which is VCE. So this is for only a few tenths of a volt where during the saturation region of operation by the transistor, and VC, and here from here we can say that VCE is also a few tenths of a volt at saturation. So we can say the saturation region will be lying very close to the zero voltage axis. That means zero voltage axis means it will be lying very close to the zero voltage axis. This is the voltage axis. Close to the zero means around this area, around the origin area, where all the curves coincide and fall thereafter rapidly to zero. So in this area primarily is the saturation region. As you can see that all the curves here will primarily fall sharply towards the, from this side active region, it will fall primarily sharply towards the zero. So this region near to the current axis and at very low values of VCE, that is zero, the saturation region will lie. So this is all about the output characteristics of common emitter mode of operation of by the BJT. Now let us summarize before going into the next topic. Let us summarize the what we have discussed about the output characteristics of common emitter mode of operation, the three different regions of operation primarily. So we have seen what we have seen, that there are three regions: active, cutoff and saturation region. In this case, first, the primary region of operation for normal operation of BJT is where the middle of the output characteristics, that is when the value of VC is between 1 and 40 volt. So if you consider this characteristic curve once again, between 1 volt and 40 volt in the voltage axis of VCE, the active region at the middle portion of the characteristics will lie. This represents the normal operation of the transistor, and in this region the emitter diode, we have already confirmed that emitter diode, emitter junction will be forward biased and the collector junction will be reverse biased, and the collector will gather almost all the electrons that the emitter will inject into it through the base, and that is why changes in the collector voltage have no effect on the collector current in this region, and the characteristic curve will be almost parallel to the voltage axis, that is parallel to the VC axis, as you can see from the characteristic curve. So this region is the active region, and in the graph it is the horizontal part of the curve. You can see the collector current is almost constant in this region. Another region, another small region of operation that can be had in this operation, which is the breakdown region, which is generally avoided. I have already told you in the last lecture that the transistor should never operate in this region, because then it will be destroyed. So breakdown will only occur over and above the 40 volt typically, but for different transistors, the breakdown voltage may differ. That means we will never allow the BJT to operate at such a high voltage for VCE having that such high voltage value, and it is not intended to operate in that region, the BJT. Then there is another part of the characteristic curve, which is the early rising part, where VC is lying between 0 and few tenths of a volt, that is in this area, in this particular area where the voltage value of VC is very small, between 0 to few tenths of a volt. In this area, we have told you that this region is called the saturation region. In this region, the collector diode, that is the collector junction, has insufficient positive voltage to collect all the free electrons injected into the base, because we have told you that for saturation region, both the junctions will be forward biased, but the biasing applied to the collector junction will not provide sufficient positive voltage to collect all the free electrons injected into it from the emitter through the base. So that is why the base current IB is larger than normal value, and the current gain beta DC is smaller than normal value, because in spite of having sufficient value of base current, but still because of not very sufficient positive bias, forward bias for the junction or collector junction, the collection by the collector will not be that much more higher as like the active region of operation. So therefore what we will see, that in spite of having very sufficient base current, the collector current will not be that much sufficient. So in this area, the collector current will not that much be higher. So this is the region of operation for the saturation. Now another thing we can expect, that at the bottom of the total characteristic curve, you can see this represents the another possible region of operation, that is this area of operation. Here you can see the base current is almost zero, but still there is a small collector current which can be observed at this area, and this current is usually so small that it generally it is not perceivable. So we can say that the bottom curve is just drawn larger than usual value, and this region of operation is called the cutoff region. So for very small flow of collector current IC, in spite of having almost zero base current here, and this small collector current will be called collector cutoff current. So this is the region of operation for IB equal to zero. For very small collector cutoff current IC, this region of operation is called cutoff region. Now the question is, why does the collector cutoff current exist? Because the collector base junction has reverse magnetic carrier current, because you can see that the cutoff region both reverse bias. For getting cutoff region of operation, both junctions should be reverse bias. So therefore we can say for a reverse bias that reverse magnetic carrier current will flow, and along with another component of surface leakage current, you know, for a reverse bias junction. So in a well-designed circuit, therefore there will be some amount of minimum collector cutoff current, but it is so small that we may ignore that value of collector cutoff current. So this is the region of operation of cutoff region. And if we now want to get the family of curves, that is for different values of IB base current, we should get the family of curves. And if we measure IB and VCE for different sets, where VCE is plotted in the x-axis and IB for different to get the different curves, we can plot all the family of curves similar to any one curve. Other family of curves can be drawn in the active region, and all the family of curves can be seen. The collector current is constant, as we have seen in the active region. When we plot several curves for different base currents, we get a set of collector curves, as being seen in this diagram, in this characteristic curves diagram. another way to get this set of curves is we can use a curve tracer, that is a test instrument you can use in the lab. It can be used in the lab, that which is called a curve tracer, to get the different family of curves for IC versus VCE for different values of IB. Now, among all the four regions of operation we have discussed so far, mostly the three regions, because we have left out the region breakdown region of operation, which is generally not intended for. So the most important region of operation is the active region, because here the amplification of signals is possible by the transistor. So the active region is also called linear region. This active region may also be called linear region. Why? Because changes in the input signal produces proportional changes in the output signal in this region, and the saturation and cutoff regions are useful for digital and computer circuits, because saturation and cutoff region is primarily used for the region, these regions of operation primarily used for switching circuits. So they are much more preferable for digital and computer applications. So this is all about the common emitter mode of operation by the transistor. Now let us see some problem on this common emitter mode of operation. Let us solve some numerical problem. So this is a typical problem. This circuit is given and you need to find out IB, that is base current, IC, collector current, VCE, collector to emitter voltage, and power dissipated at the output, PD. Power PD means power dissipated, PD, at the output. Now you can see the diagram. The base current can be written as the solution. The base current can be written like this: IB equal to VBB. Consider this input loop. This is VBB 10 volt minus VBE. You know VBE what? This is VBE, the voltage between base and emitter, 0.7 volt for silicon junction, divided by RB, which is 1 mega ohm for this one. So this is 10 minus 0.7 divided by 1 mega ohm, that means 1 into 10 to the power 6. So this will be 9.3 microampere. Hence the collector current in this problem, beta is given as 300 beta DC. So since we have found IB, so IC, collector current, will be beta DC into IB. So that means it is 300 into 9.3 microampere, which is 2.79 milliampere. And the collector to emitter voltage, then VCE, which is VCC. Now consider the output loop. Writing this equation, you need to consider the output loop to find VCE, because VCE is the parameter in the output loop. So VCE, we can say VCC, which is 10 volt here. If you apply KVL here, it is VCC minus, VCC minus the drop in this resistance, 2 kilo ohm, which is RC. So VCC minus ICRC, because in the output loop the current that is being flown is IC, and in the input loop the current that is being flown is the IB, and we have IC and IB related through beta. Very simple. So this equation is written considering the input loop, the left side, left loop or input circuit. And this equation is written considering the output loop, the right side loop, the output circuit, this one. So this is 10 minus, what is IC? IC is 2.79 milliampere, into RC is 2 kilo ohm. So this is 4.42 volt. Now we have to calculate the PD, that is power dissipated in the output. So power dissipated means, power means V into I. So output voltage is VCE, voltage in the output circuit. So this should be VCE into I, means current in the output loop, which is IC. So this is VCE into IC. This is the output voltage and this is the output current. So product of the two is the power dissipated at the output circuit. So this is 4.42 into what is IC, 2.79 milliampere, and this is 12.3 milliwatt. So this is the answer. So this is how the problems can be solved. And if you want to draw a simplified form of this circuit, it should be look like this. Since the collector bias voltage and the base bias voltages are same, so we can have a same positive 10 volt supply voltage, and from here take two resistances, the base resistance as 1 mega ohm and the collector resistance as 2 kilo ohm, take through two resistances into the BJT, NPN BJT. The base is connected from 10 volt through 1 mega ohm, it is connected to base like this. 10 volt through 1 mega ohm, it is connected to base. We have connected something like this, and 10 volt through 2 kilo ohm is connected to collector. You can see 10 volt through 2 kilo ohm is connected to collector. So 10 volt through 2 kilo ohm is connected to collector terminal, and 10 volt through 1 mega ohm as base resistance connected to base. So 10 volt through 1 mega ohm is connected to base terminal. So this is the simplified form of this diagram, and the emitter is grounded. So this is how the emitter is at ground, and the VCE will be between these two terminals, voltage measured between these two terminals, collector and emitter. So this is the simplified form of diagram of this one. Now before doing some more problems, let us first explain two important terms about BJT. One is base spreading resistance. Base spreading resistance, it is the DC ohmic resistance. Base spreading resistance is the DC ohmic resistance of that part of the base region of a transistor, of that part of the base region of a transistor in which the base current flows, in which the base current IB flows. So in short, what is the definition of base spreading resistance? It is the DC ohmic resistance of that part of the base region of a transistor in which the base current flows. Its value depends on the dimensions of the base and the DC operating point, which we will see in our one of our next topic of discussion, what is operating point. Its value depends upon the base spreading resistance value. It depends upon the dimensions of the base. It depends upon the base dimensions, that means the base width mainly, and the DC operating point of the transistor depends. DC operating point, its typical value lies between 50 to 150 ohm. Another term is saturation resistance, which is important for study of BJTs. For a transistor operating in the saturation region of the common emitter mode, so transistor in CE mode operating in saturation region, this resistance can be measured or specified, rather we can say the ratio of, and its definition is the ratio of collector to emitter voltage, that means VCE, and the collector current IC for a given base current IB. For given IB is called common emitter saturation resistance, denoted by RCES. So it is the ratio of collector to emitter voltage and collector current for a given IB, that is called the saturation resistance. And it is important that the transistor must be operating in the common emitter mode in its saturation region. So these are the two important definitions for in case of studying of BJTs. So let us once again move into some more problems, numerical problems. Problem number 2, because previous one, this one is the problem number 1 and this one is the problem number 2. So let us see what is that problem. A transistor with an alpha is given as 0.98, is operated as an amplifier in a common base circuit. It is working in common base mode amplifier. It is working as such, with load resistance given as RL. Load resistance is given as 5 kilo ohm. If the dynamic resistance of the emitter base junction is 70 ohm, emitter base junction dynamic resistance, we have denoted it in our discussion about the theory of this dynamic resistance, Rin, small Rin, it is given as 70 ohm of the emitter base junction. Emitter base junction means it is obviously the input resistance, this dynamic resistance. So you need to calculate voltage and power gains of the circuit. So calculate AV and AP. We have seen the formulas of AV and AP in our earlier discussions. Now AV is having formula, so let us see the solution. AI, which is the current gain, into RL, output dynamic resistance, by Rin, small Rin, which is the, sorry, RL is the load resistance and Rin is the input dynamic resistance. The ratio of the two multiplied by current gain is the voltage gain. You have seen this formula in our previous discussion. And AI is given already as 0.98. Current gain, approximately alpha, is given 0.98. So we can calculate AV, 0.98 into RL is given 5 into 10 cube, 5 kilo ohm, divided by 70. 70 ohm is the input dynamic resistance, which is 70. So the power gain AP then can be calculated by AV into AI. You have seen this formula, it is a product of voltage gain and current gains. So it is 0.98 into 70, that is 68.6. So it was a simple problem. Let us see now the problem number 3. The problem says the current gain alpha of an NPN transistor is 0.98. It is given. It is connected in the CB mode. It is working in CB mode and gives a reverse saturation current ICO is given, which is 12 microampere. I have explained to you what is ICO in our discussion on theory about it, what is reverse saturation current for collector base junction to be reverse biased. So this is ICO given as 12 microampere. Now you have to find the base and the collector currents for an emitter current of 2 milliampere. Emitter current is given as 2 milliampere. You need to find, calculate emitter current IE is given, calculate IB and IC. So let us see the solution. Use the equation what we have discussed in our earlier classes. IC is equal to minus alpha IE plus ICO, considering required sign conventions for an NPN transistor. This IC and IE are oppositely directed, so minus sign is taken. So for an NPN transistor, IE is negative. So as per the sign conventions, for it is given as NPN BJT. So for NPN BJT, we have seen that IE is negative. IE should be zero. IE should be having negative value. So we can say, if we put negative IE here, so this minus sign will be gone. So IC will be, then the equation changes, alpha IE plus ICO. Now if we substitute the, from the given values, what is IC? Alpha given as 0.98 into 2 milliampere, the IE value, plus ICO is 12 microampere, 12 into 10 to the power minus 6. So from here we can get 1.972 milliampere. Now again we can write from the from applying KCL for a BJT, minus IE is equal to minus IB plus IC, or we can say IE equal to IB plus IC, whatever. Or from here IB is IE minus IC, and IE is given as 2 milliampere, and IE we have found 1.972 milliampere. So it is 28 microampere, the value of IB. So this is the problem number 3. Now let us see the problem number 4. Problem number 4 is another simple problem. A transistor with alpha given as 0.98 and gives ICO, reverse saturation current, as 12 microampere when used in common base configuration, common base mode of operation. Now when the transistor is connected in common emitter mode with a base current of 0.2 milliampere, when in CE mode with IB 0.2 milliampere the transistor is operated on, we need to calculate the IC, that is collector current. So let us see the solution. The common emitter current gain beta, you know, it is common CE mode current gain. And the formula is between because we need to find, because when in common emitter mode we need to calculate IC, so that means we need to find beta first from the given alpha, because we need to calculate IC in common emitter mode, but the data which are given here is from common base mode, so we need to convert the data from common base mode to common emitter mode, and the current gain in common emitter mode is beta, you know, so we need to use the value of alpha to get beta, and you know what is the relation between beta and alpha. We need to use that relation here. So beta equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha, this was the relation we have derived in our previous class. So 0.98 by 1 minus 0.98, and this will be 49, so beta will be 49. And the collector current expression using ICO, you know, IC equal to beta IB plus beta plus 1 ICO, we have derived this in the previous class, this expression. Now substitute all the values. 49 IB is given when CE mode, the base current IB is given 0.2 milliampere. So this is 0.2 into 10 to the power minus 3 plus 49 plus 1, what is ICO? 12 microampere, 12 into 10 to the power minus 6. So we can calculate from here 10.4 milliampere. So this is my collector current in this case. So this was the equation, and putting all the values, this was the equation we have derived, and we are using it here, putting all the values, the answer is 10.4 milliampere. Now let us see another problem. Problem number 5. A silicon NPN transistor with beta NPN transistor is given, whose beta is given as 100 and ICO as 25 into 10 to the power minus 9 ampere. It is given. Is connected in the common emitter mode, working in CE mode. Find the different different current components and the region of operation of the transistor. So you need to find different current components and region of operation of the transistor. Given VB as 0.7 volt because it is a silicon transistor. So the diagram that is given with this problem is like this. An NPN transistor, this is base resistance, this is collector resistance, this is VBB and this is VCC. This is 10 volt given, this is 200k the base resistance, IB is flowing in this direction, this is emitter, this is collector, IC is flowing in this direction, and RC is 2.2k the collector resistance. Now the solution will be like this. Let us see the solution. The base terminal, we are observing that the base terminal is positive with respect to the emitter terminal here, because the positive of the 5 volt source, the positive electrode is connected with the base and negative electrode is connected with the emitter. So the transistor is not in the cutoff region because it is NPN transistor. So positive electrode connected with P, negative electrode connected with N. So it is base emitter junction is forward biased. You can see from here the base emitter junction is forward biased. So if the transistor is not acting in the cutoff region, because you know the at cutoff region both the junctions should be reverse biased. But it is very clear from the given circuit that the input loop or the base emitter junction is forward biased. So there is no question of transistor to be working in the cutoff region. So it may either operate in the active region or in the saturation region. So let us now find which is the actual. So for finding in the actual, let us assume that the transistor is working in the active region. Now if we apply KVL to the input loop or the base emitter circuit, we can write what we may write, IB into RB. RB is the base resistance, suppose, plus VB, that is equal to VBB. This is the using KVL, this is the KVL equation for the input loop, the left loop, the input circuit. So now put all the values. RB is given as, we need to find IB, so put RB. RB is 200 kilo ohm, so 200 into 10 cube plus 0.7, that is equal to 5. So from here you can calculate IB. Therefore IB from here, it is 21.5 microampere. Now you can note that IB is far far greater than ICO, because ICO in the problem is given as how much, 25 into 10 to the power minus 9 ampere. That means it is 25 nanoampere. But IB is 21.5 microampere. So So almost it is 1000 times lesser. The ICO is 1000 times lesser than IB. So we can say that IB is far, far greater than ICO. So therefore, we can write from the current expression, the useful current expression for BJT, IC, to find IC is equal to beta IB plus beta plus 1 ICO. And since with respect to ICO, IB is much higher, so we can neglect this term beta plus 1 ICO from as compared to term beta IB. So this is approximately equal to beta IB, we can say. So no need to use this term. So from here, what is beta given? It is 100. So 100 into IB is 21.5 into 10 to the power minus 6. This much. So this is nothing but 2.15 milliampere. So IC is 2.15 milliampere. Now, in order now to show that the collector junction is reverse biased, because we have assumed that the transistor is working in active region, and already from the diagram we have seen that the base emitter junction is forward biased. So we need to prove now the collector base junction as reverse biased, and also to calculate the different current components. So we have already calculated IB, IC. Now we need to prove that the transistor is working in active region, and for that we need to just prove the collector base junction to be reverse biased. So in order to prove that, we need to apply KVL to the output loop, that is the right loop or the collector circuit. So by applying KVL to the collector circuit or the output loop, this is KVL at input loop, what we should write? IC into RC plus VCB plus VBE is equal to 10. Now why we have written the equation in this fashion? This is VCC, which is equal to all the voltage drop around the output loop. This is the voltage drop in the collector resistance. This VB is already given, and this VCB is, we need to find the VCB. Because we need to find, why we need to find VCB is because we need to see what is the polarity of the voltage between collector and base. We need to find the biasing across the collector base junction. So if we measure the voltage across collector base junction to find its polarity, whether it is positive or negative, then accordingly we may conclude that whether the collector base junction is reverse bias or not. Actually, that is what we want to do, to prove the collector base junction as reverse biased. So VB is given here, ICRC given here, and this is 10, the VCC. So we need to calculate from here the value of VCB. So IC is what? It is 2.15 milliampere, 2.15 into 10 to the power minus 3 into RC. What is RC? It is 2.2 kilo ohm, 2.2 into 10 cube plus VCB plus 0.7 is equal to 10. So from here we can calculate VCB. So if we calculate here VCB, you will find that 4.757 volt is the value. So we can say that the VCB is giving a positive voltage. So we can say that VCB can be written as VC minus VB, that is a positive value. So from here we can say that, or VC is greater than VB, that means collector is having a higher potential than base. So collector is more positive with respect to base, So in it will indicate that the collector base junction is reverse bias because it is an NPN BJT. So collector side is N side and base side is P side. So now if N side is more positive than P side, that means it will mean it is reverse bias being applied across the collector base junction. So that is what we were finding. We did want to prove that. Okay, so we from here we can conclude that the transistor is actually working in active region, because what we have assumed in the beginning is found by the found mathematically, is proved mathematically. So we can say that our initial assumption was correct, which was transistor operating in active region.